See, this is the true table of BCD to gray code converter. Here we are taking a number ranging from 0 to 16, 0 to 15, 9, this is 10, this is 11, this is 12, this is 13, this is 14, this is 15. So we have total 0 to 15 numbers. How we generated it for BCD? Simply, you have to take 8 zeros and 8 ones, then 4 zeros, 4 ones, then 2 0 2 ones, and then 0 1 0 1 0 1, like we did in the earlier case. The gray code, you have to be very careful while designing. Gray code is designed by taking XOR of these two, that is 0 0, then it is 0, then XOR of next two, then XOR of next two, and last one is fixed. Hope you understand how the gray code is made. I already made one video in which I show you how to generate a gray code, so I advise you to just saw that. We will start it from here to design the XOR gate. I'll tell you the basic step. First of all, you have to generate a K map. See, 4x4 K map. This is A bar B bar. We already covered this thing. This is A bar B. This is A B. This is A B bar. Similarly here, C bar D bar. This is C bar D. This is C D. And this is C D bar. So this, we all know how to design this 4x4 K map. Once you design this, now you have to compute these all values G0, G1, G2, G3 by putting these values into this K map. So we'll put them, I'll show you how to put that. You can either, you can take this number like this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, or you may take it like this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. There are two ways to place them. You can place it either way, either like this or like this. So first of all, we started with the value of Z0. And we place all the G0s in this, in between this. Now see, we have to place these values inside this. So I am taking it like this. I am more comfortable by placing these numbers vertically. So I'll place it like this: 0, 1, then 1, then 0. I place these four values. After that, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, then 0, 1, double cross, 0, 1, double cross, and last all cross. Now the making pairing is very important. We have to make the pair of 4, then 2, then 1. Initially we have to start with 8, since there is no 8 will form, so we have to look after for 4. See, this 4 pair is one formed here, and this, and I'll take one another color. This 4 is also formed here, and this 4 is also formed here. So all the ones are occupied in 4's groups. So this is all about the making groups. Cross is basically a don't care. You can take it 1 or 0 according to your need. We generally use cross as a 1 whenever we have to make the pair. So I'll consider it 1 here. Now the only thing left is to solve this pairs, to solve this columns, groups. With this group, I have answer C bar D, because nothing has to be taken from this vertical. And for this, we have the common here D and common here A. So this is AD. And with this group, with this group, I have CD bar. So this is the value of G0. Now similarly, I am placing the value of G1, and we'll see how. See, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. After that, 1, 1, 0, 0. 1, 1, 0, 0, and after that 0, 0, cross, cross, 0, 0, cross, cross, and at last all are cross. Now see, for making pair we need to be take these two, these zeros you have to taken with these cross and make a pair of four, and after that these ones you can't make a pair of four, so we have to make it in a group of two only, and this how all the four, all the ones get covered. Now the answer would be for G1 it is first of all I'll write here 00 01 11 10 00 01 11 10. I have to see this is 01 means A bar B, and I have to see what is a common here, that is C bar. So this is first term, and another term I'll get it is from here I'm getting C, and from here I am getting B bar. So C B bar, this is the G1. Now we are going for G2. For G2 we first of all we have all four zeros. We place it like this 0 0 0 0. Mind it, you have to place 0 0 then 0 then 0. Since all zeros we can place it like this 0 0 0 0. In all four ones, so no problem, four ones, so we can straight away place them. After that 2 1 and 2 cross, so 2 1 and 2 cross, and then all cross. Now there is a turn of making pairs. There is one octant is formed like this, and from here you will get 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0. You will get from here you get a common, that is B. So the only value for G2 is B. So for the last term you have first of all zeros, all four zeros. So I'll place all four zeros 1 2 3 4, then 0 0 0 0 again four zeros, see again 1 2 3 4, all four zeros, place it here all four zeros, then 1 1 2 cross, 1 1 2 cross, 1 1 2 cross, and then all cross. Now turn of making pair. Now there is a turn of making pairs, so we'll take these 8 as a quadrant, and the answer would be the common from these two, that is A. So this how we get G3. Hope you understand how to calculate the values of G0, G1, G2, G3. Now the only thing is left to draw its circuit. So we'll draw its circuit also. To draw its circuit with the normal gates, I already advised you, as we did it earlier. I am taking A, then A bar. Mind it, for this triangle you have to put 0 also. Similarly B, and B bar, we place a NOT gate here, then C and C bar, and at last D and D bar. These are the equation. Now we have to draw its circuit. This is very easy. First of all we are realizing this C bar D, so for this we need AND gate C bar and D, then AD, we need AD also, for that A and D, then we need AD, this is A and this is D. So this is A, this is D, and at the end CD bar. So we need C and D bar, and after that we want to O-ring this. So we'll do the OR of all these three like this, and this is G0. Very easy. For G1 similarly we have to make G1, that is A bar B C bar, A bar, then B, and then C bar. So this is C bar, this is B, this is A bar. We can put it like this also, no problem. And then we need one more AND of C B bar. This is C, and this is B bar, C B bar, and after that we have to OR them. So this is how we generate G1. For G2 it is very easy, only B. So for G2 we just have to take B. This is simple, G2, which is equal to B. Similarly for G3 we need A, so we have to just take A, simple, as a G3. So this is a circuit of gray code converted from the BCD. Hope you understand the circuit. And similarly we can design this whole circuit with the universal gates also. For that I'll advise you to just go and watch the video of how to design a circuit with the universal gates. What important tip you understand from this is you can design any kind of, you know, any kind of code converter, but you have to be careful about its truth table. Once you know its truth table, you can easily do the mapping of the K-map and generating the equation. And while generating the equation, you have to be careful while making the groups. You have to start with the 8, then gradually move to 4, then 2, and then 1. If you know each and every concept, I don't think so you get stuck anywhere. So I advise you to just go through the truth table of each and every code carefully. Likewise, I want you should convert, like here it is given, BCD to gray. Similarly, BCD to accessory input. Here you have to understand, after BCD after 10 there are not defined. That I already explained you in the one of my video where I explained all the codes. And then accessory to BCD. Here you have to understand the first three inputs are 0 because accessory starts from 3. So, and these are cross or don't cares, because after the 10 means 9, all the other outputs are don't care. So once you know how to design the truth table, it is very easy to map it with the K map and find the equation, and then you have to convert it circuit by using either basic gates or by using universal gates. It depends upon the question. So hope you understand, and you can design all these code converters very easily. If you face any problem, then you may contact me in the from the inbox or by commenting in the commenting below in the comment box. I'll try to solve your problem as far as can I possible. So till the next video, stay tuned. Thank you.